there's been a lot of community momentum here at the school. Is that something that is going to be important for you going forward?
Yeah, it's one reason I wanted to come. Like I said, I came here growing up. My cousin lives here. You know, my parents hopefully here. My wife's mom is coming with. So when I say community, it means we're bringing everybody with. I want to raise my kids here, go to school locally. Everything we do is going to be part of the community. The worst thing we can do with all this momentum and all the fans is slow that down. So I know how important that is. Kids want to play in front of great crowds. The fact that we have that right now makes it really easy.
Coach, how challenging is it to just to come in and try to create fast relationships? And you talked a lot about the players there and to keep them, you know, out of the transfer portal and try to keep the team together. How challenging is that process?
Yeah, I mean, in today's culture, we would say a challenge scale, that'd be 10 out of 10. But if FAU was today's culture, then this wouldn't happen. And the reality is they were great because they worked through COVID. They stuck together as a class. They stuck together to see who the next coach was. And the only reason it becomes easy is because of who they are and what this place is. And I didn't know what it was going to be. And when I walked in the locker room, frankly, it could have gone before, but it went the opposite. They're all going to be here, but it means they're giving us a chance. And to get a chance nowadays is almost impossible. So even if it's a 10 everywhere else, it doesn't have to be that here.
Coach, I don't want to sound fast, but what do you mean?
What I mean?
Yes, sir.
I think sometimes things in life line up because they're supposed to. And most of the time in this profession, you get where you need to be because of relationships. And the reality is that the white family throughout athletic sports as a whole has been instrumental. Ryan's whole family, athletic director, besides a coach. And they know a lot of people. And so what happens in these deals is everybody wants the job, and they start calling around. And to be honest, I think I have this job because of what other people said about me. I think hopefully 80% of this was done before I even started my interview, because the people that I love me back. And I think that's what it was. I just got lucky.
Last year for FAU, they really boosted their non-conference schedule and put it on a national landscape. What is your opinion on that, and is it something you see playing in a lot of tournaments like that?
Yeah, scheduling's super important. One of the things we're going to address this week right away. What you do before Christmas is a big deal. Obviously, when you come off the Final Four, you want to schedule that way. The last staff did a great job of that. I need scheduling from our view at Gonzaga, so I've been getting on the landscape of that. I understand how the net works. I know you got to do certain things in order to make the tournament. And it's not just play well, but scheduling is a big deal. And as far as the conference is concerned, you want a better conference. Because the better the conference is, the more it becomes a chance to be a multi-bid league. And so we want to make the tournament, but to be frank, we want the American to have more than one team. And so the scheduling as a whole is important, but we'll make sure we do a good job there.
Would you all step into a situation of basketball that you have, considering the dusty disappeared over the last 2 years? And you've seen it in your career with people stepping into areas, into jobs where their futures are spending on the rise. You're not shying down. You know, people have told me you would never shy away from something like that. What is that challenge, rather than going into a situation where someone is fired and everything is going the other way?
Yeah, you have two choices when a program's really good. You can run away from it or you can take it on. And I'd rather take it on. And the truth is you can take over a program in a bad place with bad fans and people that don't care and pretend that you can just fix everything. And that's not what I wanted. I wanted a program that had fans and had good players and had success. And I wanted to continue something that was really important to the community. I didn't want to have to trick the community, but I wanted one that was already behind the school. My impression is that's true here. People want to be good, they have to be good, and I'd much rather have that pressure than the other pressure.
Coach, how meaningful is this day to you with all the sacrifices that you mentioned for your family and just waiting for the right time for something like this to happen, and now that it's here to experience it, how much is that when you reflect on it?
Yeah, it's a different guy. And I'm just going to tell you that I wasn't nervous about the speech at all. I was nervous about the crying, and I knew I would be some. And you just can't put into context the way Gonzaga and Baylor saved my career and helped my family. And if you said I had to wait a little bit to get the right one, then both Marcus Scott told me to do that. So that's what we've done. And that's why this means so much.
Coach, what this team needs right now?
They need to stay together and stay at FAU. And if we can make that happen, then we'll do it. There's going to be two rules at this point. One leaves, we'll have to replace it. We can't play basketball with the rest guys. But when we bring a recruit on campus, this group gets to decide if they stay or not. We will not hide our recruiting. They'll be involved with it. We're lucky enough to keep a core group here together. They're going to get to pick their teammates. And so we're not going to lie to them. They're going to be a part of the process. They've earned the right to decide who plays with them. So we're going to go about it that way.
Coach, long-term recruiting international portal of this high school. Previous staff was really comfortable in a certain sweet spot of going after under-recruited or underrated players and doing a good job. You've had a little bit of, you've been aiming higher a little bit recently. What's going to be your sweet spot long-term in terms of recruiting here?
Yeah, I think on the whole that you just have to address needs. I would say if you just look at the guards at Baylor, for example, the ones that have gone pro were all American. Adam Flagler had no offers. He had one offer at Presbyterian. ACOT, played point guard at Asheville, and had to transfer up. Davion Mitchell was top 50, and they had to transfer to find the right place. I think more than anything, we're going to use our analytical models and the NBA background checks that we do to pick the highest character kid. And character means a lot more than rank. And if you look at it, like Jeremy Sohan at Baylor, he wasn't ranked in the top 100. And so he ends up a lottery pick, but he didn't start that way. So maybe people thought he was highly ranked, but he wasn't. And you can find talent in different places. And I know this international kids love the beach.
Speaking of the course, Coach May recruited talented players for the 2024 class. What is your message to them to make sure they stick around for the long term?
I called the three Americans last night and talked to somebody really close to the Lithuanian. He's on a different time zone, but we're going to get him real soon. And, I made sure to reach out. We're not just going to lose the class, lose the class. I know that the relationship with Dusty is super important. And I understand that, but just like the guys that we got to recruit that locker room, we're going to try to recruit that class.
Two more questions.
Outside of the recent success FAU has had, obviously, two straight tournament appearances in the Final Four, what really stuck out about this head coaching
process? I felt like I could be myself, and I felt like Brian was giving me a chance to be on a culture that exists, but in a way that reflects what Baylor and Jagger did. And, worked for two guys that didn't go anywhere and they found a sweet spot. I just felt like that's what this
was. Last question.
You mentioned that some of the players could possibly be coming back next year. Have you spoken with any of the previous staff members about possibly coming back to fairness on their staff?
I met with every staff member yesterday. That's the very first thing I did. So I went from interview to locker room with the players. The next morning, by 11 o'clock, I had met with this one. So I think that's probably for Dusty to decide on some of that. But as far as being the best person I could and connecting with them, I definitely did that. And we'll see how things fall. And we've already talked to them. So I think I did the very best that I could to honor them.
Who's the student athlete who had a sign that said, fear the beard? What do you think of that?
My wife's the one who convinced me to grow the beard, so it's going to stick around for a while.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you, Coach.